What's up guys, this is Sahil. So today I'm going to be talking about the RTX 5070 Ti. Yeah, it just launched a couple of days back and it's here. No one can get it. You want to buy it, you can't buy it. But yes, who else better than Sahil to have this card? It's the MSI Ventus 3X version. So here's the card. There's a couple of interesting things about this GPU that I'll tell you. If you want the generic charts with all the games, yeah, tons of reviewers on YouTube have done that. I'm not going to talk about all of that. You want that information, you go there. Don't come to Sahil for that common information, because Sahil is going to give you some pretty special, unique things about this card, things that really make this actually a pretty interesting proposition. This is the RTX 4080 Founders Edition. Now, NVIDIA did not release a Founders Edition for the 5070 Ti. Man, those Founders Edition GPUs are just amazing. Like, they're very, very durable. They're very long-lasting. I've never had a problem with any of the Founders Edition cards. They're very silent. They just look like a nice high-end gadget inside your PC. Whereas the partner cards, they look a little, you know, like a toy. So I weighed both of these cards. This thing weighs a whopping 2.1 kilograms, whereas this weighs 1.05 kgs. That's exactly half of what this weighs. So it's good for the planet Earth because less materials have been used to make this. Why it's great? Because this thing performs almost the same as this. But you know what? That's what every YouTuber will tell you, but not me, because this thing actually performs a little better if you know how to get that performance out. I'll just summarize where the 5070 Ti stands. It's around 1-2% slower than the 4080. It's around 3-4% slower than the 4080 Super, 7-10% faster than the 4070 Ti, and around 30-35% faster than the 3070 Ti. So that's a good gen-on-gen gain compared to the 4070 Ti. They're both made from the same architecture, from the same 4 nanometer architecture. So, I mean, I didn't really expect that great rasterization boost in the 5000 series. And yeah, everyone's saying that though the 5000 series is a failure. Well, you know, it's what you expect. Like, don't set your expectations too high and don't fall for the marketing practices. Yeah, I know the guy in the leather jacket was like, yeah, you're gonna get 4x performance, blah 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 blah. Just don't fall for that. I mean, these corporate guys, that's what they're gonna do. It's their job to do it, but don't fall for it. It's what I expected and it's what we got. Yes, they have made some f-ups. Like, the 5070 Ti's, some of them have been out in the market with lesser number of ROPs. Yeah, that sucks. I checked the ROPs on mine and they're as advertised. So yes, I'm never unlucky in these things. So you know what's so special about this card? It's overclocking potential. I went into MSI Afterburner and I did like step up overclocking till I reached the limit. In the core clock, I reached a maximum of 425 megahertz. And in the memory, I was able to reach the maximum, which was 2000. You can't go ahead of 2000 megahertz. In MSI Afterburner was not allowing me to increase the power limit more than 100%. So I don't know why, maybe it's locked over here. That overclock gave me a 10% boost in Black Myth Wukong. So, you know, Black Myth Wukong is, it can get pretty brutal on even the RTX 5000 series GPUs. Like, with the ray tracing set too high, it can really punish GPUs. But I was able to get a stable above 60 FPS speed with DLSS in performance mode and ray tracing set to medium. With ray tracing set to the highest level, then my frame rates were around 40-45. With the overclock, I was achieving an average FPS of around 67 to 68 frames per second. Without the overclock, the same number came down to 60 FPS. So that's a 10% boost. And now with the 10% boost, we're entering into the performance category of the 5080. So that is really, really great, because the 5080 is so much more expensive than this. It's a very heavy architecture. It's got more physical horsepower than this. So that's great that this GPU is able to overclock and reach the performance at that level. You know, what makes it even more special is that I analyzed the temperatures and the power consumption. So the power consumption never crossed 285 watts. But that's funny, because this GPU, the TDP has been increased from 285 watt to 300 watts, because in the 4070 Ti Super, the TDP is 285 watts. In this one, is 300 watts. But I was still never really crossing 285 watts. So I don't know why. Maybe it's a driver thing, or I don't know. I can't, you know, I won't comment on it. The temperatures actually never went beyond 67, 68 degrees. And that is just great. This thing never really got loud. And I was like, wow, it's not really making that much noise. And it's not really getting that hot. It's not crashing. It's not giving me any artifacts. I'm not getting any BSODs. That's great. Actually, that's very rare when you overclock in graphic cards. There are moments when you have to suffer either one of these things. I've been gaming with this overclock in Cyberpunk, in Wukong, and in Last of Us. Not a single crash. Beyond that 425 megahertz core clock speed, Yes, that is when I started receiving the crashes. But that was also after like, you know, 10-15 minutes of gaming. So 425 is the sweet spot for at least my GPU. Now that really puts things into perspectives, because see, the 4070 Ti Super right now is available for around 85,000 rupees. The official pricing of NVIDIA for the 5070 Ti is 80,000. Obviously, we won't get the graphic cards in NVIDIA's official price. I mean, we're not getting them in the US. How are you expecting us to get them in India? I think roughly when this card does actually hit the market, maybe we'll be seeing prices of around 1.1 to 1.2 lakhs. Seeing the market conditions, seeing what this GPU is offering, the fair price would be around 95,000 to 1 lakh rupees, and at that price it makes sense, because the 5070 Ti will give you a performance that is almost equivalent to the 5080, and that is great. So yeah, overall I think this is a very interesting card. I'm still studying the multi-frame generation, which is NVIDIA's new offering for the RTX 5000 series. Now I tried multi-frame generation 2x, 3x and 4x in Cyberpunk, and man, yeah, I mean 4K multi-frame generation, you actually don't even need multi-frame generation 3x, 4x. 2x, you're pretty sorted. It's very stable, plus 60 FPS with everything maxed out, like ray tracing set to psycho, all the sliders set to extreme. So yeah, multi-frame generation, I think, is a game changer. So to summarize the performance of the 5070 Ti, you know what? I was expecting the 5070 Ti to be an ultimate 4K gaming GPU. I was hoping for it to be the entry point for high-level 4K gaming, but sadly, that is not the case. Yes, using the frame generation technologies, using DLSS and MFG, you can get there, but without the frame generation technologies, yeah, it's still not the 4K GPU that I was hoping for. But this is an ultimate 1440p GPU. Like, you can't go wrong in 1440p. And even for 4K, actually, if you use the frame generation technologies, you're gonna get playable 60 FPS plus frame rates in most games, if not all. Yes, games like Black Myth Wukong, and I'm expecting games like Microsoft Flight Simulator to not really give you that 4K performance with the 5070 Ti. Yeah, this is still the most interesting GPU of the RTX 5000 lineup. And I'm just waiting for this GPU to hit the shelves in India and see what price it is. Just take note, I'm saying that it should be around 1 to 1.1 lakhs, maximum 1.2 lakhs, but let's see what happens. Sahil out.